I moved my family to Budapest in 2002 because Campus Crusade needed help to build its multimedia capabilities in reaching the former Soviet part of the world. I just had skills and I had spiritual gifts, and there was a very clear need. And I know that there's no greater feeling in this life than doing what God has prepared you to do. To say that it's been an adventure is an understatement. What I've discovered is that since the collapse of the Iron Curtain, these 18 countries that we serve are looking for their lost identities. The generation that we're trying to reach is absolutely transfixed by Western technology, by open expression. But on the other hand, I've also discovered that Campus Crusade was absolutely not quite using their multimedia potential. Fortunately, that has changed dramatically. We're not only using visual nuances to communications, but we are teaching national believers to use it and to teach others in their own countries to use it. Campus Crusade basically follows the same model that it uses around the world: win, build, and send. So as our media team has developed, that's exactly how we have decided to develop and to deploy multimedia communications. As far as winning people to Christ, using multimedia tools, you are doing something that is extremely satisfying, extremely gratifying personally, to create something that you know is going to be changing lives. The My Story version of the Four Spiritual Laws booklet is probably one of the best examples of this. It's just simply a personalized, customized expression of this tried and true model for reaching people for Christ. Another example of winning is the continual use of short film in a lot of ministries across Eastern Europe and Russia to start discussion of spiritual topics. We not only help national staff to understand how to use this abundance of short films that are out there in the world, but some of our staff have even decided to create their own very good short stories on film. In fact, we're currently working on using the Jesus film material to present the story of Christ in a fresh way through the animation form known as anime. Whereas the 1979 Jesus film doesn't necessarily reach all of the 15 to 30 year olds throughout this particular part of the world, we're confident that some kind of animation will be able to do that, and that's a really exciting project. Now, building of our team takes the form of showing nationals how to extend their own ministry impact by understanding how to use multimedia tools. I think one of the most fulfilling aspects of my ministry is being able to visit places like Poland and Ukraine and Albania and a few other places we've been to, and show them how to do video production, how to do audio, graphics, web technologies. And we make new friends in the process, we're building relationships, we are continuing to train them through a website which we've developed, and it's precious, absolutely wonderful to discover people and places and to serve God in each of those places and to sort of see the development of the kingdom in process. One example of building was our creation of the training package for the ministry called Story of the Soul. We helped this portion of the campus ministry develop this training website, and then once we were done with that, we actually took a trip to Croatia and we videotaped an example of this sort of coffee shop style outreach as it was actually taking place. And of course, you know, there's no better way to train somebody and how to do something than to show it to them.
What is hope? What? How would you define it?
Something that makes you alive. Something that makes you want to live.
So in a sense, we're taking people to Zagreb, Croatia to see the story of the soul going on. And I think that's a really valuable way to learn something. Thirdly, we are also helping to send God's people further by helping them to explain their own ministry visually and dynamically to their own ministry partners. No one can do that as well as they can. So giving them the tools to do it is very effective. There's no question that raising support is a lot easier when you can actually show what's being done across these 12 time zones that we're in. And you know, honestly, there's no question that living in Eastern Europe takes adjustments. I would say that probably the biggest adjustment is language. But beyond that, the discovery of the culture is completely energizing. It's very exciting. there's a lot of satisfaction associated with discovering why people do the things the way that they do them. And adventure is everywhere. My kids have an expansive view of the world because they have been able to live here. There's constant opportunity for travel, for interaction with people, for conversation. There's a lot of beauty across Eastern Europe and Russia. What really makes it worthwhile is the people at Campus Crusade's Eastern European Area Office. These people are the cream of the crop. When we first came here, we were completely assisted at every point that we needed anything. It's very open, it's a very joyful environment. I've experienced this great sense that this office wants me to be effectively used in the way that God has given me talents and gifts, and not to try to force a square peg into a round hole or anything like that. They trust the Lord, we worship together, we share challenges together, we share together all of the successes and the growth of God's kingdom, and we rejoice in that together. If you are a graphics artist, if you're a video editor, if you're a writer, if you're a designer of some sort, web technician or whatever, you are in a remarkable, powerful position in this day and age to connect people with the life-changing message of the gospel. This is the greatest message that there is. So packaging it, delivering this very precious treasure that we have to Eastern Europeans and Russians has taken me personally to places that I've never been. It's taking me to an unparalleled sense of personal significance. And I liken it to getting the best ticket, getting on the 50-yard line, so that you can see what God is doing as the world is being shaped around you.